Well, it's official. 21 and 21 is mathematically impossible now. The title goes to the empty hand. The Crip side of money is victorious in 2021. The pain is real, but at least it wasn't them filthy scousers. Now, I'm not a hater. As much as it pains me that the once noisy neighbors are just moving gangster in silence these days, there's no doubts after 38 games. Congratulations to the blue quarter of Manchester. Pep Guardiola is the man. 3 titles in 4 years. He's moving very Fergie-ish. There's no doubt he's taking the sport to the next level. I've been a massive Pep fan since the beginning, and quite frankly, I don't like it when people besmirch his name. Put some respect on it, thank you, please. About checkbook manager. Which successful manager didn't purchase a title winning squad? Furthermore, I beg you, look at his signings. He hasn't signed a single superstar at City. He has made them. They just cost a lot because everyone knows City have money and don't negotiate. They just splash that dough like they were in a strip club. I wish our owners did exactly the same. Glazers out! These men have got us stuck between a rock and a hard place. We look one way and we see the empty head celebrating. We look the other way and it's the scouts. We're just in between them getting mocked by our ops. I want our spot back. These men better do a City and invest this summer so we can take back what's rightfully ours. Now, onto the game itself. Man United 1, Leicester 2. Another home loss. I'm pissed that we lost, but not at the players or the manager. I'm proud of them as a whole. 10 changes. We put in youths, old has-beens, and a bunch of rusty players. It was some put-together lineup because the Premier League are also our ops. This would have never happened under Fergie. 3 league games in 5 days, but yet we have the weekend off. Are you mad? They're trying to help the scouts get a Champions League spot. Well, we had different ideas. Ollie's a red through and through. He knew what he had to do when faced with this conundrum. Step 1. Field a weakened team and help Leicester recover them 3 points against Newcastle. Step 2. Smash the scouts in their face and seal their Europa League fate. Back to Thursday night football, you go. Champs to champs in a year. How can they have been the greatest Premier League of all time? This is punishment for their blasphemy. This loss is one of those rare occasions where we still won in defeat. I'm not vexed. No. In fact, I was very impressed with some of the performances. Firstly, this wonder kid is something else. You know who I'm talking about.
Who's that, Mason?
Oi. Gunwood is firing. Them say you can't keep a good man down. You see how the vultures tried to get onto him at the start of the season? They tried to destroy him in the media. For Lincoln Gyal, they didn't call him back up for England. His close friend died. He's a teenager living his life in the spotlight. It was a tough start to the season, but this kid is the truth. And the truth will always come to light eventually. Man came out of the darkness and he's moving like a supervillain. He's taking shots and dupping everyone. Gunwood is a Leng man. All he does is
cock back, shoot, then score. Cock back.
From one wonder kid to another, Amad Diallo is on stuff. Silly, silly stuff. His feet are a madness. His touch is a madness. His dribbling is a madness. His strength is a madness. This is the most appropriately named player in football. A madness Diablo. Yes, I said Diablo. It's devilish how he moves. What a player we have in our hands. He is so techie. He's already linking up with Gunwood. The future is bright. I can see violations for defenders coming with these youths on the ball for years to come. And big up young Anthony Alanga as well on his debut. Axel Tuanzebe. I'm happy for Axel. He started the game a little shaky, a little shaky. His passing was off and he got skipped a couple times, but he's rusty. Man plays a few minutes every 15 games. What did you expect? But he grew into the game. Second half, he read everything like a children's book. You could see him finding his confidence. I have faith in Tuanzebe. He has all the ingredients. It's his lack of game time and some idiot fans abusing him online that knocked his confidence. But this was a performance to build off. Hopefully he gets more minutes in Maguire's absence. Honorable mentions to Matic and Telles too. Now, I can't end this without bigging up the two best players on the pitch for me. Yuri Tielemans and Wesley Fofana. I can't talk highly enough of these two players. They should both be United players. Tielemans has been cold since he was 16. What a baller. As much as people know he's good, he's still too underrated. He's always fit. He always puts in the work. He's always efficient and effective with his passing. And he always influences the game. He is a top, top player. And Fofana, this is a next level you. I've said it before and I'll say it again. He will be a top 5 defender in the world within 3 years. Remember, I told you that. I would be ecstatic if we signed him this summer. Anywho, onto the scouts. Let's give them a slap and make them ugly cry on the bus back to Scoutsland thinking about Ryanair destinations. It was all good just a year ago. Come on, United. Thank you, please.